Okay, so I want to show you how to make a simple picture frame and apply a texture to it. So I'll just hide this one that I've already made. Let's just take a look at the image that I want to attach to this. So it's here in my furnitures files and it's in my source images. It's this painting. And let's just take a look at the properties of that painting. If I look here, its dimensions are 1184 by 666. So let's make a plane that has those qualities here in Maya. So I'm going to make a plane. I'm going to move it up in space. Oops, let's go back inside the house. Move it up in space. And if we take a look at it, it's got a lot of divisions, which we don't need. So in my channel box, I can just take those divisions out. Make it so it just has one division. And you can start to scale it up, but really what we should do is pay attention here to the scale. So let's say we want it to be, what was that image again? Just 1 second. It is 1184. So let's make it 1184. There it is. Let's say in Z, 11.84, and then by 666. Okay, it's kind of funny. So in X, we'll do 6.66, and there we go. So there we have something in the same aspects ratio or same size, more or less. So I'm just going to tilt it up. So in rotate, you could just rotate it by 90 degrees over here in the channel box. And say we want to put it on this wall, maybe we want to rotate it again 90 degrees there. So that's fine. And we can put it against the wall. If it feels a little too big, you can scale it, but scale it from the center so that you're scaling it in proportion. So it'll still remain in the right, aspect ratio for that image. Okay, so scale it from the center. Now let's extrude it. So I'll just push it against the wall just a little bit more. You don't want it to disappear, but hang on the wall. Let's extrude it. So you could either go up to change the modeling. You could go up to edit mesh and go to extrude here, or you can do Command E. So select the object and Command E, and then you can just pull it out in that direction. So that's great. Let's do that again. So extrude again, Command E, and or you can press G for last done. And now let's just scale it in a little bit because we want the next layer to be kind of scaled in, right? And then we want the next one, we want to extrude it one more time. So extrude again, and then this time just push that in a little bit because that makes it have some dimension. You can see some dimension there. Okay, so we extruded it a few times. If you look here, you can see we did it once, twice, and three times. Okay, so that's our object there. It's been extruded three times. That's great. So we can select the whole object and we could put a new material on it, maybe just a regular Lampert, right? And if we look here, we can see that we have a new Lampert attached to it. We could also delete its history and it just is a little simpler. We could maybe make the frame have a kind of brownish color. But then we want to select the center face. So if I go into face mode and just select the center face, we can apply a new material to that because that's where we want our image to be. So again, go into face mode, select the center face. Right mouse click and hold, assign new material, and you could just do another Lampert because it can be flat. But here we're going to add a texture, so click on the texture node there and go to File. And then if you click on here, I have my project set correctly, so it knew to go to my furniture folder and source images, and I'm going to find the Leonora Carrington. And you can see it's kind of applied sort of strangely, so let's just deal with that. I'm going to click on the object, go to UV planar, and let's do it from let's see, if I turn on my move tool, I can see that I want to project from X because if I have my projector out here, it would be an X. So let's project it. And, oop, that wasn't right. Let's try that again. We'll do, let's try planar Z. What the heck? Project. And there it goes. You can see you can kind of move it around and it sort of tiles. You could scale it in and have it tile if you wish, but that's how that works. So again, in order to, if it has a funny look to it when you project it, you can go up to UV planar and figure out which dimension you want it to be from. You could also go up to UV and you go to the UV editor and you could kind of figure it out from there if you want to. Okay, so, and we'll do some more UV editing, but that's just kind of the very simple version of that. And for some reason, when you look here you're here and you don't, and it doesn't go immediately to the correct folder, you may want to set your project. So file, set project, and just make sure it's set to the project that has that, that has that image in it. So I can see here in my tutorials in my furniture that I have that image there. So, and another way to check that, I'll just close that, is to check on my render settings here. And I can see that I have the proper path here. So the project is indeed correctly set. So that's how you do that. And I hope that works for you. Thanks so much.